All right, so for today's happy hour, I wanted to revisit the champagne cocktail. So what you've got to do is you got to buy sugar cubes from the grocery store. I bought these from the Jewels.
Yes.
All you got to do is soak the cubes with Angostura bitters, which I have right here.
Okay.
And you can see what they kind of look like. It changes their color. That's what they look like, all right? And then all you got to do is put the cubes inside flutes right there.
Easy enough.
And then all you have to do is pour a little champagne into it.
Ooh,
and the nice part
is
as the sugar cube dissolves, your cocktail will change in taste. It'll become a little bit sweeter. And if you want to do something, whoopsies. If you want to do something a little.
Party foul.
Yep. And you want to garnish with a little bit of a lemon twist. Now some recipes also recommend that you add a little bit of cognac to it. Recommend like Hennessy or Cavassier, and an orange twist. So that all just kind of depends. So that's a little champagne cocktail. It kind of like, helps extend your champagne. And then on top of that, if you don't want to buy the most expensive champagne,
a generous woman.
It helps. I'm so sorry. It's not bubbles if it doesn't bubble
over.
Hey,
it's New Year's.
All right, and then I want you to know, plan ahead, don't drive, secure your groceries for Hair of the Dog the next day. So go ahead and buy your favorite Bloody Mary mix. This is personally my favorite, Zing Zing. You can buy it at the Jewels or Mariano's or wherever. And all you have to do is to make sure that you have this ready to go on the first. You add vodka. You add a little bit of lemon or lime. You can do a shrimp skewer. You can do a cheese skewer. Whatever you want to do.
As long as you have the celery salt.
But I do recommend that you put it in a shaker and actually shake it with ice. And then, of course, have a garnish. Now, the origins of the cocktail aren't exactly clear. Now, many people think that the origins of the drink were from Harry's New York bar in Paris in 1921. A hangout for Americans like Humphrey Bogart, Ernest Hemingway, and Rita Hayworth. Now, others say it was named after a server. Mary, listen to this, Andrea, who worked at a saloon bar called the Bucket of Blood in Chicago. Now, others also say that it's named after the Queen Mary Tudor of England and her bloody reign. So, regardless, it'll still jumpstart your day.
It's still
after
delicious.
A night out, and it'll cure what ails you.